In this short movie, I will demonstrate what a statistician means when she says that the mean is the balancing point of a distribution. We can think of the distribution as points on a seesaw, and the mean is the pivot point or fulcrum that balances the distribution. So for example, in this picture, the person on the left weighs 100 pounds. The person on the right weighs 50 pounds, only half as much. To balance the seesaw, the 50-pound person must sit twice as far from the pivot point as the 100-pound person. Now let's represent this idea using a dot plot. Here, the mean is at zero. We have two data points on the left representing the 100-pound person. The person is sitting 30 units below the mean. We have only one data point on the right representing the 50-pound person. This person is sitting 60 units above the mean. The balancing point for this distribution is at zero, and this is why the mean is zero. Another way to think about the balancing point is to think about how far the data points are from the mean. The mean is the value that balances the distances on either side of it. So for example, in this distribution, the mean is at 7. It's marked with a red triangle. The distances of the data points from the mean are shown as red line segments below the dot plot. So for example, the three data points at 11 are each a distance of 4 units above the mean, and you can see their distances recorded down here. The distances to the right of the mean total 13 units. So 1 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4 is 13. Similarly, if we look on the left side of the mean, or values below the mean, the distances will also total 13. So for instance, this data point at 1 is 6 units below the mean, so that's a distance of 6. If we add up similarly the distances of the other data points that are below the mean, we get 13. Now, if we view deviations below the mean as negative, and deviations above the mean is positive, then the sum of all those deviations from the mean will be zero. To see this, I will use a tool that measures the deviation or the signed distance from the mean. Points above the mean are going to be recorded as a positive distance. For instance, the data point at 90 is 10 units above the mean, which is at 80. Now, if a point is below the mean, for example, this point, then the distance will be recorded as a negative number. Let's see if we can get it to do that. Yeah, negative 20. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is just click through the distribution to show that the sum of these signed distances is going to equal zero. So let me start my counting here. That's a distance of 10 plus a distance of 20 plus another distance of 20. Okay, so now I'm at a total of 50. If I sum the distances or the positive deviations above the mean, I get 50. Next, we're going to look at the negative deviations. Okay, so there's negative 20 plus negative 10 plus negative 10 plus another negative 10. That's negative 50. So the sum of the deviations or the signed distances above the mean was positive 50. And when I added up the negative deviations of the data points below the mean, I get negative 50. Now, the point that is actually at the mean, of course, has a deviation of zero. So if we sum the total deviations, we would get 50 plus negative 50 plus zero, and this equals zero. To summarize, the mean is the balancing point of a distribution. It is the place where the distances of the data points above the mean equal the distances of the data points below the mean. This is equivalent to saying that the sum of the deviations or signed distances from the mean will always equal zero.